you a friend of God?
Amen.
I am a friend of God. He called me friend. Amen. Today, just for a little while, if you are down, will you stand? Verse 18 and 19. And it simply reads, the Spirit of the Lord is upon me because he hath anointed me to preach the gospel to the poor. He has sent me to heal the brokenhearted, preach deliverance to the captives, and the recovering of the sight to the blind, to set at liberty them that are bruised, to preach the acceptable year of the Lord. Now, Heavenly Father, we come now to expound on your word. We thank you for this opportunity, God. We ask you now to remove me from self. Oh, God, take my place. Stand behind this sacred desk. Speak to your people the words you desire that they hear. Anoint me right now from the crown of my head to the soles of my feet. Oh, God, that they see less of me and more of you. As we stand on the wall of this gospel, we ask these blessings in Jesus' name. Amen. As you go to your seat, I want to talk for a few minutes from this subject, in times like these. In times like these. Perhaps some don't see the impending danger that beset us. Perhaps some are too comfortable with where they are in their lives, that they feel they don't need any protection. They feel they don't need to pray. They feel they don't need any help from anybody. They just rather be left alone to live out the existence of what they call life. In times like these, the word has declared that men would become, with their ears would wax cold. They won't be hearers of the truth, nor dividers of the right word. In times like these, Paul told Timothy that perilous times will come when men will not listen to sound doctrine. They will not heed to the word. They don't want to listen to what's right, but rather they listen to what's wrong. And in times like these, we find ourselves entangled in such times. Now, the problem is, how did we get here and what do we do to relieve ourselves from where we are? So, but it's in times like these that we need to hear good news from heaven. Now, I don't care what anybody says, sometimes you need to cheer, you need cheering up. Sometimes it costs you a little something because you got to leave your comfort zone to hear the truth. And if somebody was to tell you the natural truth, sometimes it makes you angry, it upsets you. It don't settle well with you because you are in a place that you're not really wanting to hear the truth. But it's in times like these that word from heaven kind of cut down those walls that keep us from hearing what is the gospel truth. Yes. Come on, somebody. Amen. And we can just hear a word from heaven. We notice that sometimes things don't seem as bad as that we think they are. Yes. You know, sometimes we wish we had gobs of money. Well, we wouldn't have to worry about anything. But I bet the difference with you, if you had gobs of money, you worry more. Come on, somebody. You worry a little bit more because you always got to be on guard thinking somebody is going to take it. Now, there's not a mother that's sitting in this house can tell me that before she had children, she was worried about her sibling, her children. I know she didn't because she didn't have any. But as soon as she had children, you begin to worry about your children. You got to take care of them. You got to make sure they don't get sick. And when they do, you want them to be healed and cured of whatever is wrong with them. You want to protect them. You want to give them safety. You want to give them a sound home. You want to make sure that they're brought up right. All those things go with mothering that you didn't have to take care of before. But now, when you hear from heaven is saying how to be a good mother, that's when you start paying attention. But if you were a rich person, not a one of y'all be sitting in here this morning. I said it. Right now, if you had the money, think about the places you would be. And it would not be Ebenezer Missionary Baptist Church sitting on the corner of Roundtree and Hanley Street. And if you say you would be here, lie your pants on fire. I know that it seems like that all of that will help us out, but it is the good news from heaven that will carry us from point A to point B. Money can't save you. Your possessions can't save you. I don't care how many funeral possessions you've seen, you've never seen a Prince truck behind the hearse. It's usually the family car. And 2 weeks after you are put in that cemetery, nobody go to visit you. Don't care a thing for you. But it's the good news we need from heaven in time like these. Number two, it's in time like these that we need someone to heal our broken hearts. I know that some of us may not show it. Our face don't exhibit the feelings that we have inside. But you can't tell me that you have not carried that hurt around in you for such a long time. You've been hurting, but you still manage to smile. You've been disappointed, but you still manage to smile. You've been stabbed in the back, but you still manage to smile. You've been talked about, but you still manage to smile. Nobody knows how you hurt. I heard somebody say one time, don't nobody know but me and the Lord how bad I'm hurting. You need to hear from heaven when it's like that in times like these. Some things can be said to you that were not your born, rock you to your core. And it's by the folk that you love the most.
Amen.
That seem to hurt you.
Yeah.
But why is it then that we try ourselves to heal ourselves? When we know that the church said we got a friend in Jesus. And he will heal our broken hearts. Yes, he will. In times like these, we need a Savior to deliver us from our sins and captivity. We're so wrapped up and tied up in things that we're not so sure of nowadays. Bro Sauls, it seems like everything that we thought was wrong when we were growing up is right now. What the law said that we couldn't do, now we can do. I heard Paul said, I want to forget those things that are behind me, because I want to press toward the mark of the high calling of God. We gotta learn that only Jesus, only Him, can save us and deliver us from Satan's grip.
Amen.
A lot of times we look to people for different solutions. It's not them that has the solution. We need to understand that God places certain circumstances in our way just to get our attention. Oh, yes, he does. If you had your way, you'd be happy-go-lucky. Wouldn't know what it is to shed a tear every now and then. If you had your way, you'd never be naked. You'd never be without some shoes. Well, with some of us, no, ain't going to be without shoes no more, because you were without shoes when you were small. So you decided when you grew up, you're going to buy enough shoes that you won't never be barefooted no more. Come on. Yeah, myself. I know I had to put cardboard at the bottom of my shoes just to go to school and had holes in it. And so I decided when I got up, I was going to have enough shoes that I could change and would never wear the soles out. Come on, somebody. I got to admit that. That's the way it is, children. Y'all don't know nothing about that yet because you still getting supplied by your parents. But there'll come a time when you're going to want to buy things for yourself. You're going to want to get everything for yourself. And you're going to figure, well, I can do all of this for myself. But one thing that you cannot do is deliver yourself from your sin. You need a Savior to deliver you. And that is in the person of Jesus Christ. He found that when he came down to this earth, there were many who rejected him. As of today, folk don't want to believe that God is still the answer. They don't want to believe that Jesus still exists. Just because you don't see him, he still exists. I heard him tell his disciples on one occasion that because this blind man's faith was, his faith was greater than theirs. Simply because he could not see. But see, if you got faith in all that you see,
amen,
the devil will put obstacles out there to fool you every now and then.
Yes, he will.
I know for a fact that things may look all right now. But God is getting ready to do something real great. We better stop resting on our laurels and start paying attention to the signs. Yeah, what we need to understand is not about the commercializing of Jesus' birthday. It's not about all the things that we want and expect from other folk. It's not about what we seem to expect from ourselves. But it's about what God will do for us. He will deliver us. Yes, he will, from all our transgressions. Yes, he will. He'll throw them in the sea of forgiveness. But one thing that we must understand and we must try to do, that's fall down on our knees and ask God for forgiveness. He will.
Yes, he will.
He will forgive us. Yes, he will. If we ask him for deliverance, he will deliver us. Yes, he will. I see the people back in the Bible days when Jesus went in the synagogue on the Sabbath day. Yes, he did. And the man of God stood up to read from the scripture.
Yes.
But then he delivered the book over to Jesus. For some reason, he knew there was somebody that was in church that had a little more than he had. He realized there was somebody that was in church, had a little more spirit than he had. Lord, help me here. So he turned the book over to Jesus, and it was turned to the book of Isaiah. And Jesus began to read, said, the Spirit of the Lord is upon me because he has anointed me to preach the gospel to the poor. I want you to know today that Jesus was anointed to give you the right word to make you rich. Maybe not in substance, but it made you rich in the spirit. He said he has sent me to heal the brokenhearted. If you don't know by now what it takes to heal a broken heart, call on Jesus. He's standing by. Yes, he is. He said he could preach the deliverance to the captives. If you're still bound by all your sin and shame, God will. Stand back. before. You'll be able to see things a little bit clearer.
Yeah.
Without your glasses. Yeah. Spiritual battles.
Yeah.
You'll be able to discern. Spiritual battles. You'll be able to understand. Walking the street.